this session is on clock part 2, okay? Please like, share and subscribe this school channel. Please look at the part 1 also. It is very important to understand the part 2 session, okay? We will be solving the problems of an angle with and without any formulas, okay? Please subscribe this school channel. Computing important formulas of an a clock, okay? I will explain in both theoretical method and formula method how to solve the problems, okay? Now, basically questions would be asked on find the angle between hours and minutes. Okay. Now coming to first one. The angle between hours and minutes and of an clock is, if you consider something like hours and minutes and what is the angle between these two, then we will be using this particular formula. 30h minus 11n by 2 mod is equal to angle. What is a mod? Mod is nothing but if you on substituting the values, if you got the angle of minus 20 degrees, if it is in mod, then becomes in a 20 degrees only. Minus would not be there, okay? Always the angle would be in a positive, that's it. Now coming to the next one. Number of minutes taken by hours and minutes and of the clock to coincide, combine together. If you consider the minutes hand and hours hand are coinciding with each other, okay, they are just coinciding with each other, then it angle is nothing but 0 degrees. Then you will be using the same formula and angle will be 0 degrees, and we will be finding number of minutes taken by them to make an 0 degrees. It's nothing but coincide, combine and together. In the questions it will be asked 30h minus 11n by 2 mod is equal to 0 degrees, okay. Coming to the next one, right angle. What is a right angle? Right angle is nothing but when the angle between minutes and hours and is nothing but 90 degrees. Okay, then it becomes nothing but a 90 degrees. Then it would be substituting the value of angle as 90 degrees and substitute the value such that it would be getting number of minutes taken by them to make a right angle. Okay, now coming to the next one, straight line. When the minutes hand and hours hand form in a straight line, okay, and minutes hand and hours hand make in a straight line, then angle is nothing but how much? 180 degrees, right? So it just will be substituting the value as 180 degrees, then it becomes 30h minus 11 by 2 mod is 180 degrees, and we find the number of minutes taken for them to make a straight line, okay? It's not that combined coincide and together, right? So we'll be substituting the values and find the number of minutes taken by them to make a straight line. Theoretically, we'll be explaining you how to solve this particular problem also. Next, we'll be finding out the angle between hours and minutes and of a clock. Okay, the shorter one is called hour hand, and longer one is the minutes hand. Okay, by knowing this one, you can solve the problem very easily. No need of using any formulas or so, okay? We'll be going one by one. The first one is, in 1 hour, the hour hand makes 30 degrees, okay? In 1 hour, the hour hand makes 30 degrees. If you consider this one, the shorter one is nothing but hour hand. The longer one is nothing but minutes hand, right? If the hour hand moves from 12 to again, it moves to 12, okay? It rotates, then it makes an angle of 360 degrees, right? So you can write as in 12 hours it makes an angle of 360 degrees, right? So for 1 hour it will be equal to 360 by 12, which is equal to 30 degrees. Okay. If you consider from 12 to 1, okay, the shorter hand moves from 12 to 1. Then it is nothing but 30 degrees, okay? From 1 to 2, the hover hand moves, then it becomes in a 30 degrees. From 2 to 3, also it is 30 degrees, okay? If you consider from 8 to 9, okay, it is also 30 degrees, okay? Now coming to the second one. In 1 minute, the longer hand moves 6 degrees, okay? In 1 minute, the long hand moves 60 degrees. If you consider minutes and the long hand, if it rotates, okay, from 12 to 12, it is 60 minutes, right? Which is nothing but 360 degrees, right? So we can consider as in 60 minutes, at most 360 degrees. So for 1 minute, how much it is? 360 by 60, which is equal nothing but 60 degrees. So for 1 minute, from here to here it is 1 minute, then makes angle 60 degrees. From here to here it is 1 minute, makes angle 60 degrees. So for 1 minute, the long hand makes 60 degrees. Okay. Now coming to next one. In 1 minute, the hour hand moves 1/2 degrees. Okay. As you know this one, right? In 1 hour, the hour hand moves how much? 30 degrees. Right? 1 hour is nothing but 60 minutes. It moves 30 degrees. Right? So for 1 minute, how much it is? It is equal to 30 by 60, which is equal to 1/2 degrees. Right? So if the minute hand moves from 12 to 12.1, okay, 12 to 12.1, it is 1 minute, right? Then the hour hand moves only 1/2 degrees. Right? You have to remember this one, the basics thing. If you remember this one, it is very easy to solve the problem. Okay. Come to the first question. Okay. Find the angle between hour hand and minute hand of a clock when the time is 3.25. Okay. It is given that time is 3.25. Right. It is in a hour. It is in a minute. Right. 3. The shorter one is in a hour. The longer one is in a minute. Right. In a watch, we'd be considering 3.25. First would be solving by theoretical method, next would be solving by a formula method. Okay. First one, theoretical method of solving the problem. Okay. We will consider a clock, the time is 3.25. Now as you know, from 3 to 4, the angle is nothing but 30 degrees. Right? From 4 to 5, also angle is nothing but 30 degrees. So total angle from 3 to 5 is nothing but 30 plus 30. Which is equal to 60 degrees, right? But answer is not 60, as the hour hand would be also moving within a minute's hand, right? As we know, the hour hand moves for 1 minute, 1/2 degrees, right? As we know, 1 minute, the hour hand would be moving 1/2 degrees. Now, how many minutes it has moved? 25 minutes. In 25 minutes, the hour hand would be moving how much degrees? Which is equal to 25/2, which is equal to 12.5 degrees, right? So the hour hand would be moving for 25 minutes, angle of 12.5 degrees. Okay, it will be moving down. So from angle from here to here is nothing but 12.5 degrees. You have to find the angle from here to here. Right. As you know, from 3 to 5, it is 60 degrees, and from here to here, it is 12.5. So, answer is nothing but 60 minus 12.5, which is equal to 47.5 degrees. So, answer is nothing but 47.5 degrees. Now, using a formula method. We know the formula, right? It is nothing but 30 H minus 11/2 minutes, right? Mod, we consider the mod is equal to angle. You have to find the angle. Here, our H is nothing but 3 and minutes is nothing but 25, so it becomes 30 into 3 minus 11/2. Into 25, which is equal to 90 minus 11 into 25 comes as 275/2, right? When you divide by 2, it becomes 90 minus, it becomes 137.5, right? So it is nothing but -47.5, right? But mod is considered, right? For each one, mod is considered. So answer is nothing but as mod come into picture, it becomes positive 47.5. So answer is also 47.5. The same method, the theoretical method of solving the problem, this is a formula method of solving the problem. Going with the next question. Solving both by theoretical method and formula method, okay? The question is, the angle between a minute's hand and hour hand of the clock when the time is 8:30. Here the time is given as 8:30, right? 30. It is an hour, it is a minute. By solving by the theoretical method, in a clock, it is 8:30, right? The shorter one is hour hand, the longer one is nothing but minute's hand. Right, it is 8:30. Now, angle from 6 to 7 is 30 degrees, and 7 to 8 is also 30 degrees. So, angle from 6 to 8 is nothing but 30 degrees plus 30 degrees, which is equal to nothing but 60 degrees. Right, now, as the minute hand when it moves, the hour hand will be also moving. Right, when the minute hand moves, the hour hand will be also moving. As you know, 1 minute, the hour hand will be moving how much? 1/2 degrees. Okay, for 1 minute, the hour hand will be moving 1/2 degrees. So here it is moving from 12 to 6, 30 minutes. So for 30 minutes, the hour hand will be moving how much? Which is equal to 30/2, which is equal to 15 degrees. It moves an angle of 15 degrees. So 8 will be moving up by 15 degrees. So total angle from here to here is now 15 plus 16. Right? 15 plus 16, which is equal to 75 degrees. Right? As you know, from 6 to 8, it is moving 30 plus 30, 60 degrees, right? And 8 will be moving up. From 8, the hour hand will be moving up with the minutes by 15 degrees. So total angle is nothing but 60 plus 15, which is 75 degrees. So answer is nothing but option B. Now solving by a general formula method. You know the formula as 30 H minus 11/2 M mod is equal to angle. Okay. If it is negative, it will become a positive for mod. Right? H is nothing but 8. M is nothing but 30. Right? So it becomes 30 into 8 minus 11/2 into 30. Right? It becomes 15, right? Which is equal to 8 3 is 24. It becomes 240 minus 15 into 11 becomes 165. So which is equal to 75 degrees. As it is positive, no need of an amount, right? It becomes 75 degrees. So here also answer is nothing but 75 degrees. A clock is starting at noon, but 10 minutes past 5, the hour hand has turned through, it is twice, the smaller hand will be turned through how many degrees, okay? This is not a formula based question, okay? The general knowledge we have to know to solve this particular problem, okay? And we going with the question. It is given that a clock is started at noon, okay? There is a clock here. It has been started at 12 o'clock, okay? The smaller hand has been started from 12 o'clock and it becomes by 10 minutes past 5. 10 minutes past 5 is number 5:10. Okay, the hour hand has been moved down, right, till 5. Due to 10 minutes also, the smaller hand would be moving a bit down till here, right? So we have to find the angle from 12 to this particular point, how much angle has been done by the smaller hand, right? The smaller hand is nothing but the hour hand. The larger one is the minute's hand. Right? So see here. From 12 to 1, we know it is 30 degrees. From 1 to 2, it is 30 degrees. 2 to 3 also 30, 3 to 4 30 degrees, 4 to 5 also 30 degrees. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 into 30 degrees, which is equal to 150 degrees, right? So from here to here, it form a 150 degrees. The extra angle has been created due to the minutes, as for 1 minute, the our hand will be moving 1/2 degrees. We know that, right? Here the minutes has moving 10 minutes, right? So for 10 minutes, our hand will be moving how much? It is equal to 10/2, which is equal to 5 degrees. Due to the minutes hand, the smaller hand has moved a bit down by 5 degrees. Right? He passed 150 degrees, he has passed 5 degrees. So total angle is nothing but 212, to this particular point is nothing but 150 plus 5, which is equal to 155 degrees. So answer is nothing but option B. Coming to next type of question, okay. The reflex angle between the hands of the clock at 10:25 is, okay. We can use the general method or the formula method to solve this particular problem, okay. I'll be using the general method to solve this particular problem, okay. Not the formula method. It'll be taking in a clock, okay. In a clock, it is 10:25. It is in a hour, the smaller one. The larger hand is at the minute's hand, right. So, due to the minutes, the smaller hand will be moving a bit far. Okay. Now we have to find the angle from here to here. As we know that from 5 to 6, it is 30 degrees. Right. From 6 to 7 also, it is 30 degrees. From 7 to 8 also 30 degrees. From 8 to 9 also 30 degrees. From 9 to 10 also, it is 30 degrees, right? So, it is nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It is nothing but 5 into 30 degrees, which is equal to 150 degrees, right? So, angle from here to here is how much? 150 degrees. We have to find this particular angle, extra angle created due to the minutes, right? So, as you know, for 1 minute, the hour hand would be making 1/2 degrees, right? For 25 minutes, the hour hand would be making how much? 25/2 degrees, which is equal to 12.5 degrees, right? 12.5 degrees. So this angle is nothing but 12.5 degrees, right? Then the total angle from here to here is equal to 150 plus 12.5, which is equal to 162.5 degrees. It was 162.5 degrees, right? Till here it is fine. See, here they are asking for reflex angle, right? What is a reflex angle? Reflex angle is nothing but which should be greater than 180 degrees and less than 360 degrees, right? So, it is not a reflex angle. So, we will be subtracting with 360 degrees. 360 minus 162.5, right? It is a point here. Then it becomes 5, this becomes 7, this is 9, it is 1. So the angle is nothing but 197.5. We can write this one also as 197.5. So answer for this question is option A. Next type of question is, at what angle the hands of the clock are inclined at 15 minutes past 5? It is nothing but just in a formula method you can use it. Just it is asking for the angle at 5:15. Okay, it is a hour, it is in a minutes. Okay, just you can use a formula method or general method. If I use a formula method, it is nothing but 30 h minus 11 by 2 m mod is equal to angle, right? So m is nothing but 15, h is nothing but 5, right? So it becomes 30 into 5 minus 11 by 2 into 15. It becomes 1, it becomes 7.5, which is equal to 150 minus 11 into 7.5. It becomes 82.5, which is equal to nothing but 67.5. So answer is nothing but 67.5. If you use the general method, see, if you use the general method, it is an minute hand. The larger one, the smaller hand is nothing but a half a hand, right? First we have to find the angle from here to here, right? 3 to 5. Due to the minute hand, the smaller hand will be moving a bit far, right? So we have to find this particular angle also. Here you can see that it is 30 degrees here. From 3 to 4, 4 to 5 also 30 degrees. So it becomes 30 plus 30, which is equal to 60 degrees, right? So again, it is moved a bit far due to the minutes. So for 1 minute, the hour hand will be moving 1/2 degrees. So for 15 minutes, the hour hand will be moving how much? 15/2, which is equal to 7.5, right? From here to here it is 60 degrees. From here to here it is 7.5 degrees. So the total angle from here to here, the total angle is equal to 60 plus 7.5, which is nothing but 67.5 degrees. We'll be getting the same answer. Okay. Next step of question is, what is the angle made by hour hand and minute hand if the clock shows 9:15 p.m. Okay, it is just nothing but an asking an angle at 9:15. That's it, right? So here you can use the formula method or general method to solve this particular question. Okay, if you consider the general method to solve this particular question, okay, it is a clock here, it is forming at 9:15 here, right? So the smaller one is on the hour hand, the larger one is on the minute hand, right? At 9:15, it is forming in a straight line, it becomes 180 degrees, right? Now, due to the minutes, the smaller hand will be moving a bit far. Okay, we have to find this particular angle, right? As you know, for 1 minute, the hour hand will be moving 1/2 degrees, right? So, for 15 minutes, the hour hand will be moving 15/2 degrees, which is equal to 7.5 degrees, right? So this angle is 7.5. So now, so the angle from here to here is equal to, total angle is nothing but 180 plus here it is 7.5, which is equal to 187.5. See here, it is not asking here for a reflex angle. What is that? It is nothing but, if it is greater than 180 degrees, then it is known as a reflex angle, right? See the option. There is no answer for this question in the options, right? So it is nothing but a reflex angle. So what we do, it is nothing but, it is asked for general angle, okay, normal angle. So it be subtracting with 360 degrees, okay? Then it becomes 187.5, 360 minus 187.5 minus, then it becomes 0.5 is 2, this is 7, and this is 1. So the angle at 9:15 is 172.5 degrees, the general angle. So answer is B. don't get confused in this particular question if there is no option here, okay? Just see if the angle is greater than 180 degrees, then it becomes a reflex angle. If they are not asking for that one, go to the normal angle. Normal angle is nothing but subtract with 360 degrees, then you'll be getting a normal angle. So now normal angle at 915 is 172.5 degrees.